I'm being followed and pursued by something.
And I could feel that there was somebody behind.
I was running and I was being chased.
I'm running down the street, into a house, through the house.
Down the stairs.
Out the back.
I was being chased.
Faster and faster.
And I ran for all I was worth.
My clothes were dragging me back.
I was running away.
I was running.
And I ran.
So I run along the corridor and I run up the stairs. I keep running up these stairs and round the corner. I sometimes run down the stairs into the corridor and I keep running and running and running.
My legs wouldn't go quick enough. I couldn't get my breath to call out.
I was running away. I was running very, very fast. Somehow I couldn't stop running.
I was running and I fell over the mountain.
There was a crocodile chasing me.
I was running.
There was a crocodile chasing me. I swam as fast as I could to get away from the crocodile. The crocodile suddenly changed into a lion and then that changed into a tiger.
The animals really, I suppose, don't mean to chase me, but because I'm frightened and I run, they follow me up.
So I run along the corridor and I run up the stairs.
And some great monstrous shape walks towards me in the corridor.
And I run up the stairs.
My legs wouldn't go quick enough.
And I keep running and running and running. Running and running and running.
Up a big slope. And my legs wouldn't go quick enough.
I was running and I was being chased.
There was somebody after me, chasing me. Up a big slope.
And I keep running and running and running. Running and running and running.
I couldn't get my breath to call out.
So I run along the corridor and I run up the stairs.
And some great monstrous shape walks towards me in the corridor.
I'm running down the street, into a house, through the house, out the back, over there, somebody. I never see anybody. I know there's somebody behind me, probably, but I never see them.
It's neither a man or a woman. It's just an enormous black shape. It's just a mass of something, matter, coming towards me. A great, big, monstrous-looking mass, not a shape. Just filling up the corridor. For it's neither a man or a woman, it's just an enormous black shape in the corridor, filling up the corridor.
It's a crocodile chasing me.
I was running away.
As I ran faster, I seemed to battle against it even more. My clothes were dragging me back. My clothes were dragging me back.
I was running very, very fast. Somehow I couldn't stop running. I was running away.
My legs wouldn't go quick enough.
And I run up the stairs. The stairs are wide and stone. They're nasty stairs, institutional stairs. I keep running up these stairs and round the corner. I can't go right to the top. I just hide round the second corner, hoping no one will see me. And then if I hear somebody, I sometimes run down the stairs into the corridor. And all the time, this terrible fear that I'm only in my white liberty bodice. Only in my liberty bodice.
I'm being followed and pursued by something. I'm never quite sure what it is. Feeling of running down a staircase. I can still see the staircase, a very wide staircase in an old house. Big carved banisters. They go down in short flights. At the end of each flight, there's a large stained glass window, and I run down the stairs faster and faster, and the something which is following gets nearer and nearer, and I don't know what it is. I have the feeling that it's something which is about to envelop me in some way. It's just this feeling of being followed and pursued. I'm running down a corridor. I'm being followed and pursued by something.
I could feel that there was somebody behind and I was being chased. And I ran for all I was worth till I got to the edge of the cliff. And just as I was getting to the edge of the cliff, I couldn't remember anymore.
I can see this corridor stretching into the distance. The perspective of it just fading into absolute nothingness.
I couldn't remember anymore.
I was running very, very fast. Somehow I couldn't stop running. I came to the edge of a great big cliff.
And just as I was getting to the edge of the cliff,
I couldn't get my breath to call out. I went up, right up to the top, over the other side, and hung on to the cliff.
I could feel that there was somebody behind.
It was some form of beast. It was some form of great ape, and it was loping along, and it was making a noise, an uncanny noise. And my clothes were dragging me back, as if I'd been in the water, and my clothes were heavy, and they're becoming heavier, and they're being held by the streams of wind. As I ran faster, I seemed to battle against it even more. And it seemed more difficult to stay on this edge. It was very dark all the way round, and it was a very sharp edge. I knew that if I watched and kept breathing properly, I could keep on the top of this ridge.
Then I sort of felt myself falling over the cliff.
I was falling.
Falling over the cliff. Falling over a cliff.
Suddenly I'm falling. I'm falling upright.
I was falling and twisting.
I'm falling upright.
Slow twist, head over feet, stretching out, increasing in speed. Mouth open wide, but no sound.
It's in space. Feeling of space and nothingness. Nothingness.
Started off by floating. Held up by my garments, which had already held me back. Somehow I started to accelerate. Gather speed, and I accelerated more and more and more. My head was down. I was speeding downwards into some great pit, accelerating all the time and increasing in speed, tumbling and falling, no more floating at all, just tumbling and falling and accelerating all the time, faster and faster. I felt as if I was falling forever.
Not quickly, but I am definitely going down, 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 and I know that nothing, nothing can stop me. I try sometimes to think in myself, oh, this is lovely, you should be enjoying this, but I'm so panic-stricken. I know this is the end, and I've finished. I'm just sinking, sinking into this great black void. I see no clouds at all. I was falling through this water. It was all around me, this water, and I didn't like it. I was falling, I got my legs in the air and my hands out. It was all around me, this water, and I didn't like it. I got my legs in the air and my hands out and my arms outstretched, and suddenly all this water became full of other people and other things all falling, full of other people and other things all falling, and chairs and tables and things like this. And all these people were all floating downwards through this water, all going downwards the same as I was. People like me with their arms outstretched and their legs, all going downwards the same as I was, and chairs and tables and things like this. And all these people were all floating downwards through this water. People like me with their arms outstretched and their legs. And I put my arms out and tried to catch hold of them. And I tried to catch hold of them.
All I can remember is falling into the water, which was very dark and very deep.
All floating downwards through this water, all going downwards the same as I was.
Accelerating all the time, faster and faster, accelerating all the time and increasing in speed. I was speeding downwards.
Sinking into this great black void.
Reeling down into a sort of chasm. Reeling down into a sort of great big hole. It was a long way down. And I felt myself falling. It was a long way down. I couldn't do anything about it. I fell off the edge of the mountain. It was very dark. Seemed to go down and down and down. Seemed to go down and down and down. It was a long way down. I couldn't do anything about it. It was very dark and very deep. It was very dark and very deep. Seemed to go down and down and down. Seemed to go down and down and down.
I'm falling upright. I've finished. I'm just sinking into this great black void. I see no clouds at all. It's in space. The complete feeling of space and nothingness. Everything is black and I fall and fall and fall. And I know that if I don't pull myself up, if I don't forcibly stop myself, I'll die if I reach the bottom. So I make a tremendous effort to stop myself. I must stop myself doing this. I jump in the air and there's a great big jump. Then I've stopped dying. A complete feeling of space and nothingness. I see no clouds at all.
I'm standing on an embankment. I'm very high up. I'm looking down on a landscape. On a vast landscape. It's all dry.
It's a scene that one would never see or never has seen in one's life.
It looks like the moon because it's all dried up. It's a very funny red. It's like the moon.
It was the atmosphere, it was the air, the freshness of it all. And as I looked, I could see the mountains. They seemed to be round me and yet far from me, as though I was somewhere that was so high and so very fresh, a freshness that I've never felt before. It seemed to be in a foreign country.
And in the distance, a black cliff. A big, towering black cliff.
The scene is always sort of rather grey and dark, rather misty.
And then the sun began to come up over the mountain. So the sun began to rise. And instead of being mist and fog, there was a most glorious sunshine and a beautiful sea.
And I saw this very deep blue sky, and these beautiful white clouds. They weren't rain clouds. Beautiful white clouds were mounting and mounting and mounting. And that was the whole scenery.
It's a scene that one would never see or never has seen in one's life.
I can remember great big blue feeling of clouds, blue sky and clouds.
I went over lots of fields of things I seem to remember. Lots of fields of things.
And there was a very deep blue sea.
I could hear this voice. This woman singing. I couldn't hear what she was singing. It was a foreign voice. But her words were clear, although I couldn't speak the language that she was singing. Her words were clear. I knew that I was somewhere foreign. Seemed to be in a foreign country.
It looks like the moon because it's all dried up. It's a very funny red.
Getting hazier and hazier.
It's the colour of earth, but the red is kind of a terracotta red. The whole of this landscape, the whole of this surface of the land is broken up and dried up like a riverbed, as though it's made of clay. All of it is cracked. It's just like the moon. It's all dried up and cracked into hundreds and thousands of cracks and holes. It's like the moon. It's red. The whole of the surface of this land is red.
Getting hazier and hazier.
The colour of clay, I suppose. Yes, it's the colour of clay, and it's all broken and cracked over, rather like a clay pot or something like this. And the sun has dried the whole of this surface. It's just like the moon. And in the distance, a black cliff. Big towering black cliff.
And I looked into the distance, and as I looked, so the sun began to rise, began to come up over the mountain. Glorious sunshine. and I looked into the distance.
And I could hear this voice, this woman singing. I couldn't hear what she was singing. It was a foreign voice. I knew that I was somewhere foreign. Seemed to be in a foreign country.
And I saw this very deep blue sky. This very deep blue sky. And there was a very deep blue sea.
Drown again, and I would surface again, come up again. Then I would go down into the water, and I had the sensation that I was going to drown, and it was frightening and suffocating.
My clothes were dragging me back.
It was all around me, this water. I didn't like it.
And I began to feel very frightened.
It seemed to go down and down and down.
My clothes were dragging me back.
It was very dark and very deep.
The sea is very deep.
I seem to be drowning.
I am going to drown. And I thought, well, it's no use trying to think I'm not going to drown. I am going to drown.
And it was frightening and suffocating. No reflection in the water.
I was in the water. And it was a feeling as though the water was coming towards me.
And I began to feel very frightened.
And being that I can't swim and afraid of water, it seemed a greater fear.
And then I would go down into the water, and the sea seemed vast, and there weren't many waves. It wasn't a stormy sea, but it was a frightening sea. And they were sort of bluey colours.
bluey-greeny colours,
and it was all colours like the rainbow, as if there was a light shining behind it.
And then I would shout and say, I won't do it, I won't do it, and I would surface again.
I saw a cloud of spray rising high up into the air, and it was all colours like the rainbow, as if there was a light shining behind it. I saw a cloud of spray,
and I had this sensation that I was going to drown, that I would surface again, and I would start to drown again, and I would surface again, come up again. Then I would go down into the water, and I had this sensation that I was going to drown, and it was frightening and suffocating.
It was all around me, this water. I didn't like it.
And I began to feel very frightened.
I must tell my mother.
All I can remember is falling into the water. It was very dark, and falling down, down, down. It was very dark and very deep. I seemed to be drowning.
I must tell my mother.
My clothes were dragging me back.
The sea is very deep. I go into the sea, and then I go right down to the bottom, and there's some land there. The land at the bottom of the sea.
It's very still, it's flat. No reflection of the water.
Lovely clear water. The water looked to be rather sort of bluey.
I didn't like it. And suddenly all this water became full of other people and other things, all falling. Full of other people and other things, all falling. All going downwards, the same as I was. And chairs and tables and things like this. And all these people were all floating downwards through this water. Chairs and tables and things like this. And I put my arms up and tried to catch hold of them.
And I began to feel very frightened.
I was in the water. And it was a feeling as though the water was coming towards me. And being that I can't swim and afraid of water, it seemed a greater fear. And as I sort of pushed back, and I felt I was pushing back the water, so I felt the mud in my hands. And then I seemed to be clear the mud, which was really saturated with water. And as I pushed and pushed, so I came across something, and I was still pushing, and I knew it was somebody. And I felt them. I could feel the shoulders, then the face, and then I could feel this tin hat. And as I pushed the hat one side, the helmet one side, so I could see my youngest brother's face. And then I felt him, knowing a little about first aid and that, I felt him and felt down the body. And as I got to the hip, he more or less shuddered. And I could see by his face that he was in pain, even though he had the mud and stuff on it. I pushed the hat back, and I thought to myself, I knew he's safe, he's alive. I must tell my mother.
He just wasn't, because he was dead.
He looked like him, but he just wasn't, because he was dead. I just walked towards him. I just picked him up.